And exercise 6D, okay, which is based on multiple sub-multiple angles. Okay, anybody completed at least half of it?
Sir, I completed full, sir, except periods.
Okay, that's good. Periodicity and extreme values, if anything is there, you can neglect. Okay, try to complete the IP exercise 6D by tomorrow as far as possible. And now we'll start transformations.
Okay.
Okay, what is today's date? 17th?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, transformations. See, many trigonometry formulas will be using practically in many other places very frequently. Okay. What is this transformation? See, is that transformation basically is converting addition into product and product into addition or subtraction basically. Okay. Sometimes you'll have sum of two trigonometric value functions. You have to write it as product. Sometimes you have to write product as sum. So transforming addition into product or product into addition. That is a word. That's why this word is there used. We already know this formula that sine, let me write something before. I am going to take a plus b as c and a minus b as c, d. If I take c plus d, I will get a plus b plus a minus b, which is 2a. If I divide with 2, I can write a as c plus d by 2. Similarly, if I take c minus d, it will be a plus b minus a minus b, which is 2b. If I divide with 2, I can write b as c minus d by 2. Okay. So now, some formulas which you know earlier, we're going to write in a different way. First one, sine a plus b plus sine a minus b, we all know it is 2 sine a cos b. Okay, if I take a plus b as c and a minus b as d, let us see what will happen to this formula. But before that, I want to write this formula reverse, we'll be using many times. That is 2 sine a cos b is equal to sine a plus b plus sine a minus b. We can use this formula many times to convert product into sum. At the same time, I can take a plus b as c, a minus b as d, a as c plus b by 2, b as c minus d by 2. So I want to convert everything into c and d. Then this formula will become sine c plus sine d is equal to 2 sine c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. Okay, so we'll be using this formula. We'll see in questions how to do it. So LHS to RHS, we have done questions in complex number, sorry, compound angles itself. But this LHS to this RHS, we'll be doing some questions now. This is our product to sum. Sum to product, we'll use this. I can give a simple example. You don't have to write the example part. Up to here, you can write. Let us, somebody may ask me, find the value of sine 78 plus sine 42. This is C and this is D. I'll use this formula 2 sine. What is 78 plus 42 by 2?
60 degrees, sir.
60 degrees.
And cos 78 minus 42 by 2?
18 degrees.
18 degrees. So I know this value, I know this value. It is that. Something like that. Okay. Sorry, you cannot see some part. But okay, so like this, we have four more formulas. We'll write them. I'm erasing the upper part up to here.
Sir, one second.
Okay, upper part of what I wrote is very simple. I took a plus b as c, a minus b as d, and they wrote a as c plus d by 2, b as c minus d by 2. Okay, if I take minus here, sine a plus b minus sine a minus b is 2 cos a sine b. reverse it. 2 cos A sin B is sin A plus B minus sin A minus B. And if I take this as C, this as D, it will become sin C minus sin D is equal to 2 cos C plus D by 2 sin C minus D by 2. This is for product to sum or difference. This is for difference or sum to product. Okay, this first point everybody copied, right?
So sorry, sir. 1 minute, sir. 1 minute.
Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, third point. Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B is 2 cos A cos B. We know that. But we'll be using many times in reverse. That is 2 cos A cos B is cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. And if I take this as C, this as D, cos C plus cos D is 2 cos C plus D by 2 and cos C minus D by 2. Okay, I'm arranging the second one. Cos A plus B minus cos A minus B is minus 2 sin A sin B. So usually when you write reverse, 2 sin A sin B, because of the minus, these two will become reverse. I'll be writing cos A minus B first. Next, cos A plus B. And from here, if I take C and D, cos C minus cos D is minus 2 sin C plus D by 2 sin C minus D by 2. Okay, so in this chapter, only these four formulas only. There are two more formulas which I'll discuss after doing enough questions on these formulas. That's all. Otherwise, no more new formulas in transformation chapter. Now, yes, please.
Sir, like cos and sine we covered, sir, based on tan?
No, tan we don't have anything like tan C plus D plus tan C minus D. Even if it's there, we write sine by cos, 2 cross multiplication and do that way. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
If it is product or sum, doesn't matter. We write tan as sine by cos and we use one of these models. Okay, now what we are going to do is... directly in the mains material, whatever is there, both even and odd, all the questions we'll do together in the class. The reason is you have quite a bit of IP work. You have to complete 60, and then whole 60 is also based on transformation. So because of that, only transformations, even and odd together, will go in the plus.
Sir?
Yes, please.
In IP?
What?
In now we should do 6D for and submit yesterday. Sorry, tomorrow till 6D, no sir, and 6E day after tomorrow.
Not exactly 6D. Try to complete by tomorrow. I'll clarify doubts. Then you can submit 6D by day after tomorrow in the app. Okay. And tomorrow onwards, you can start doing 6D. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. So all the 4 points everybody wrote, right?
Yes, sir. Wrote, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. First point of the first question in the name. Cos 6, cos 24, cos 72. Cos 6 degrees, cos 24, and cos
72. Sir?
Yes, please.
We can multiply both numerator and denominator by 2, sir.
Yeah.
You can solve it.
Yeah. One thing in trigonometry, especially, is in our intermediate textbook itself, many things are quite extensively covered. Okay. Even for mains and advanced also. Very few things only we need, and that we are giving in our mains and advanced material. Okay. So otherwise you don't find much difference between IP or mains or advanced. You look at past year mains questions, past year advanced questions, you will realize that. Okay. Now coming to this, we already know cos 72, which is same as sin 18. Only we don't know these two. But we know their sum is 30, we know that value, and we know their sum difference is 18. So what I will do, I'll multiply 2 divided with 2 here. 1 by 2 into, and I want to write this first. 2 cos 24 degrees, cos 6 degrees, cos 72. So the beginning questions are about converting product into sum. 2 cos A cos B. What is the formula for 2 cos A cos B? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Like that, cos 24 plus 6 plus cos 24 minus 6. Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Okay, this is cos 30 degrees and this is cos 18 degrees. I hope I copied the question correct.
Yes, sir.
No, this is sin 24, sorry. Sorry. This is sin 24. This is also sine 24. Oh, this also some answer will come. Not that it will not come. But 2 sine A cos B, this formula will be wrong. 2 sine A cos B will be sine A plus B plus sine A minus. So it is sine here, and this also sine. This is sine and sine. Okay. So sine 30, we know 1 by 2. Sine 18 degrees, we are supposed to remember root 5 minus 1 by 4. This also sine 18 root 5 minus 1 by 4. But this and this, if I take LCM, it will come root 5 plus 1 by 4. Because I have to write 2 by 4 and 2 minus 1 is 1. A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So we'll get half into root 5 whole square minus 1 square by 4 into 4. That is 4 by 4 into 4, which is 1 by 8. So 24 and 6 are new angles, we don't know about them, so we try to write the product as them. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to erase first one. Anybody needs more time? Okay, no. Okay, second question, they wanted the value of sine 12 degrees, sine 24, sine 48, and sine 84. If it is all our cost, I would have easily done another method because double of 12 is 24, double of 12 is 48, double of 48 is 96, which is 180 minus 84. Whenever you have product of cost of many angles where every angle is double of previous angle, we have a formula for cos theta into cos 2 theta into cos 4 theta cos 8 theta. Am I right?
Yes, 1 by 4 cos theta.
Some 1 by 8 or 1 by 16, something is there. But here all are sine. So what to do? I am particularly want to combine these two. Because if I take these two, their sum is 36, but their difference is 12, is not a known angle. But if I take these two, what is the sum of these two?
60, sir.
60, sir.
And difference is?
30, sir.
Both are known values. We know their sine cos value. Similarly, 24 and 84, their sum is?
108, sir.
108,
which is 108 to connect 90 plus 18, and we'll get sine 18 or cos 18. So it is a known angle. And difference of 84 and 24 is 60. So when you would apply transformation for 4-5 things are there, which two, if I take, it is convenient. Well, before only try to think that their sum or their difference should be known to you. So I'm going to rearrange it. I'll multiply and divide it two times. And these two together, I'll write to 2 sine 48 degrees, sine 12 degrees. These two together as 2 sine 84 and sine 24. Multiplied and divided with 2 here, multiplied and divided with 2 here. 2 sine A, sine B. This is our fourth formula, is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. So I can write cos 48 minus 12. Minus cos 48 plus 12. Similarly, this is cos 84 minus 24 minus cos 84 plus 24. Okay, so this is cos 36, this is cos 60, this is also cos 60, and that is cos 108. I can write 90 plus 18. Okay, so 1 by 4 cos 36 minus 1 by 2. This is sine 80. We know cos 36 is sine 54, and we know value of this is root 5 plus 1 by 4. And this is root 5 minus 1 by 4. If I simplify, it is root 5 minus 1 by 4. Here it is 2. Cos 90 minus cos 80. Cos 90 plus 18 is plus sin. Sorry, minus of minus sin is plus sin. It plus. It will become root 5 plus 1 by 4. Again, A minus B into A plus B. C is A square minus B square. We'll get 5 minus 1 by 4 into 4. So we will get 1 by 16. Yes, please. May not be always true, but many times when you have product of the sine or cos, you'll get 1 by 8, 4 things means 1 by 16, 5 things means 1 by 32, like that, they usually come sometimes. Where are you? Okay, anybody any doubt in the second one?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. Anybody needs more time to copy this?
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Okay. Those are completed. You can see third question on the screen. You can try that. Third question, you can do by two methods. You can write cos theta by cos alpha equal to cos beta and apply transformation. Or the given tan, you write tan by cos, multiply and divide by 2, and you can apply it proper transformation.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, in this question, second question, if we take angle A as 12 and angle B as 48, then also we'll get...
Not a problem, because 12 minus 48 will be minus 36. You know, cos minus theta and cos theta are same, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so...
Oh, okay. Same.
Okay, third question. Tan theta plus alpha by 2 into tan theta minus alpha by 2. As I said already, connect cos theta by cos alpha and apply transformation to component dividend of transformation to come, or multiply and divide with 2. And also write tan as sine by cos. It will be 2 sine theta plus alpha by 2 sine theta minus alpha by 2. 2 cos theta plus alpha by 2 cos theta minus alpha by 2. It looks like 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. So you can easily say denominator is cos theta plus cos alpha, because cos c plus cos d is 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. This numerator is cos theta minus cos alpha with a minus, because cos c minus cos d is minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Minus is missing, so I have to write. Okay, so that is cos alpha minus cos theta by cos alpha plus cos theta. Now I'm going to divide with cos alpha everywhere. When I divide with cos alpha, I'll get 1 minus cos theta by cos alpha, 1 plus cos theta by cos alpha. But that is cos beta. So 1 minus cos beta by 1 plus cos beta. You know, this is 2 sin square beta by 2. This is 2 cos square beta by 2, which is tan square beta by 2. You can do this way, or somebody can write cos theta by cos alpha equal to cos beta by 1 and apply component or dividend also, you'll get it. If anybody is having any difficulty, please feel free to ask.
Sir, please don't rub that, sir.
Okay. Thank you. All right, a completed third one.
Yes, sir. What?
Yes, please.
So once explain the third step, how did you get that minus cos to minus cos?
From here to here or from here to here?
From here to here. From second step to third step, sir.
Second step to third step, okay. Look at from here to here. Cos C plus cos D is 2 cos C plus D by 2 cos C minus D by 2, right?
Okay.
So, that's all from here to here. The same way, cos C minus cos D is minus 2 sin C plus D by 2 sin C minus D by 2. Because that minus is missing, we kept the minus here. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, fourth question, they gave cos A and they're asking 32 sin A by 2 sin 5 A by 2. Okay, third question, everybody completed, right? No doubt?
No doubt.
Okay. Okay, fourth question. 32 sin A by 2 sin 5A by 2. And they gave us cos A. So I'm going to write this 32 as 16. 2. Sin 5a by 2 and sin a by 2. 2 sin c sin d is cos c minus d minus cos c plus d. So I'll get cos 5a by 2 minus a by 2 first minus cos 5a by 2 plus a by 2 next. 2 sin c sin d is cos c minus d minus cos C plus D. Okay. So 16, this will become cos 2A and this will become cos 3A. Okay. So half angles we don't know, but 2A and 3A can be easily found. You can write cos 2A as 2 cos square A minus 1, cos 3A as 4 cos cube A minus 3 cos C. Now substitute cos A as 3 by 4. So you'll get 2 into 3 by 4 whole square. Minus 4 into 3 by 4 whole cube plus 3 into 3 by 4. Take the 16 inside, you'll get 3 into 3 square minus 16 minus 3 cube plus 3 into 4. 18 minus 16 minus 27 plus 36. Okay. So this is 46 and 54 minus 43. That is 11. Okay, so neither we know this value nor with this value. So that's why we have to use transformation so that we know this minus this is 2a and this plus this is b.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, can I again explain first step to second step, sir? What did you take common?
Nothing. I just wrote 32 as 16 into 2 and these two I wrote reverse, that's all. Okay?
Okay,
and
sir.
From
okay,
here
sir.
To here, this is 2, this whole thing is C, this whole thing is D. 2 sin C sin D is cos C minus D minus cos C plus D.
Sir, from the step 16, cos 2A minus cos 3A is there, no, sir?
Yeah, this is there.
After that, how?
Cos 2A formula, cos 3A formula, submultiple angle.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. And cos A is given 3 by 4, so we substitute everywhere wherever cos A is there, 3 by 4. If anybody needs more time to understand or to copy, or if any doubt in any step, please feel free to ask. Okay, till now we have done at least 4 questions where converting product into sum or difference. Now it is reverse, converting sum or product into difference. Thank you. Okay, so fifth one, obviously they gave sum and you have to write into this product. I want to apply cos C plus cos C formula. But you have to see if I apply for these two is better, or these two is better, or these two is better. If I apply for these two, when I add, I'll get 96, not any known value. And when I subtract, I'll get 72. Yeah, I know about 72.
Yes.
If I apply for this and this, I know the difference is, but okay, even if I get cos 36 is a known value, so I think I can apply. Yeah, I can apply for these two. I can even apply for these two because their sum is 144, off of that is 72. And the difference is 120, off of that is 60. So I can apply for these two, or these two. Either way is okay. But sometimes these two may not work out nicely and these two may work out nicely. So you have to ascertain before starting that. Okay, I want to erase fourth question solution. Anybody needs more time? No. Okay, so I know their sum is 96. No, wait, if I apply these two, the sum is 96, half of that is 48. That is not any useful. Difference is only useful, sum is not useful. So better apply these two because sum and difference both should be known angles. So I'm going to write cos 132 degrees plus cos 12 and cos 156 plus cos 84. And then cos C plus cos D is 2 cos C plus D by 2 cos C minus D by 2. It will be 2 cos 132 plus 12 by 2 cos 132 minus 12 by 2. This is 2 cos 156 plus 84 by 2 and cos 156 minus 84 by 2. So this is 144 by 2 is 72 degrees. This is 122 by 2 is 60. This is 240 by 2, 120 degrees. And this is 72 by 2, 36 degrees. We know every one of them. 2 into cos 72. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. 2 into cos 120 is minus half and cos 36. 2 and 2 will cancel. We are left with the cos 72 minus cos 36. Cos 72 is sine 18. You know it is as root 5 minus 1 by 4. Minus root 5 plus 1 by 4. So root 5 minus 1 minus root 5 minus 1 by 4. Root 5 cancel. Minus 2 by 4, which is minus 1 by 2. Okay. So if I had applied for these two, I have to again deal with some 48 degrees and all that. Yeah, anyway, if you do, answer should come. But some way it may become easier, some way it may become lengthy. So we have to be careful in choosing which are the two things is best for applying transformation formula. Because it was completed, can think of sixth one again. See which two, if you combine and apply transformation formula, either sin C plus sin D or sin C minus sin D. Think about that. Most of the options are in terms of 7 degrees, cos 7 or sin 7.
Sir, we should take 47 and 61, sir, and 25 and 11, sir. Then we'll get answer.
Okay.
Yes,
yeah, if I take 47 minus 25, I'll get 22 degrees. Half of that is 11, not useful. And if I add 60 and the 72, their sum may be good, but their difference is not any useful thing for us. But if I take these two, the difference is 14 by 2, 7 degrees is good, and their sum is 108 by 2, 54, and we know sine 54 is root 5 plus 1 by 4. So I prefer to combine these two for 6-1. Okay, fifth question. Anybody any doubt or anybody needs more time?
No, sir. No.
No. Okay, so 6-1, sine 47 degrees minus sine 25 degrees plus sine 61 degrees minus sine 11 degrees. These two and then these two. So sine 61 plus sine 47 minus sine 25 plus sine 11. And we know sine C plus sine d is equal to 2 sine c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. That is 2 sine 61 plus 47 by 2 cos 61 minus 47 by 2. Yes, please.
Sir, one means like in options they give cos in terms of cos 7 degrees or sine 7 degrees, sir?
Yeah, correct. Just say 25 plus 11 by 2 cos 25 minus 11 by 2. Okay, this is 108 by 2, 54 degrees. This is cos 7 degrees. This is sine 18 degrees and again cos 7 degrees. So if I take 2 cos 7 degrees common, I got sine 54 minus sine 18. Sine 54, I think we are coming across today many times. So sine 54 or cos 36 is root 5 plus 1 by 4. Sine 18 is cos 72, both are is root 5 minus 1 by 4. You can cancel root 5. 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. So 2 cos 7 degrees into 2 by 4. That is cos 7 degrees. Okay, later on in seventh question, if you have sine C plus cos P, we don't have any transformation formula. You should have both sine, their sum are different, or both cos, their sum are different. So somebody asks you sine 8 theta plus cos 2 theta. You have to convert cos into sine or sine into cos using 90 minus theta formula and then apply transformation. So coming Sunday, you will have advanced exam. Portion will be compound angles, multiple submultiple angles, and transformations. Because when we are doing transformation, automatically compound angles is there everywhere, right?
Yes, sir.
So those who completed can try 7th question.